about love for Michael Jackson and the Jackson family, and show some respect and please listen. Please, Miss Rose Berlin.
You cannot have animals within city limits. So Michael had to have a ranch, and he came to me and he said, please don't tell anyone, because I've been trying to find a ranch for 5 years, and I don't want people to know, I don't want the press to know, so will you keep my secret? And I said, yes, Michael, I will keep your secret until we find the ranch. It'll be up to you to announce and found the ranch of your dreams. And I found it for him. And it was known as the Sycamore Valley Ranch. It was built by Bill Bone, who was the builder of the decade in the state of California. This is over 22 years ago. And Michael was only 27 years old at the time, and almost a billionaire, and I didn't even know it. I thought it was just a kid in the neighborhood whom I knew since the age of 12, and so grew up. My family used to play, my son used to go to the Jackson Estate and play with Randy and all of the Jacksons. We played basketball together. And that's really how I found, I got to meet Michael Jackson. And I was thrilled to meet him because he liked me so much and trusted me. We went places together, like to the market, to the library, and just around the neighborhood, basically. Michael loved music, and he sometimes had me take him to Tower Records on Sunset. He loved music, and he would be seen in various music stores listening to music. He bought music. Also, he checked and see how his albums were going, if they were selling or not. Michael was so gifted. He was not just the greatest entertainer and composer in the world, but he was a businessman, and he liked to see if the records were selling personally. We went to several record stores. Anyway, I'm thrilled to be here, and I'm glad that you are here. It was such a paradise when I found a Neverland for him. The day I found it for him, he jumped up 5 feet high in the air. He screamed with joy. And it was really the property he had been on when they were thrown off that property by Bill Bone. Paul McCartney was there filming and doing a video, and had invited Michael to come on the ranch to do a video with him. So unbeknownst to Michael, he was doing a video on a property that they didn't have permission to do a video. And Bone was called by the ranch manager, and the ranch manager was told by Bill Bone from Palm Desert that he's got to throw everybody off the property because no one asked him whether they could do videos or shoot films there. So actually, everyone got thrown off the ranch, including Michael Jackson. And this is the ranch known as the Sycamore Valley Ranch. And I was shocked that Bill Bone would do such a thing, you know? But he did it because no one asked permission before, and McCartney had been a guest there for several months, just a house guest on the ranch. but finally, what happened is, when Michael wanted to find this ranch, he didn't know where it was. It was located in Los Olivos, in Santa Ynez Valley, in Santa Barbara County. He knew it was in Santa Barbara someplace, and he asked me to find it for him. And I was thrilled that I was able to do it. It took a while, maybe 5-6 weeks, and I found it for him. And it was a total paradise. The 14,000 square foot English Tudor mansion built for the Bone family. Actually, they imported all the furniture from all over the world. They imported different woods and things. And Michael was persistent. He knew what he wanted. And he got the exact ranch, the ranch of his dreams, and he was able to buy it. And luckily, I got it for him for $17 million. It was listed at $35 million. Mr. Bone wanted $35 million. And he made a deal behind my back that if Michael Jackson ever sold that ranch, he would be paid the balance of the money due on that price he put on the ranch. But if Michael never sold it, then it was $17 million. So eventually it's been sold, and I understand Mr. Bone has filed a lawsuit against the Jackson estate to collect the balance of the price on the ranch. And this is possible. In fact, there's an estate battle in court right now at LA Superior Courthouse where 500 people have sued the estate. And it's so incredible that even Joe Branca and even Catherine Jackson has filed a lawsuit too against the estate. Of course, the estate of Michael Jackson is always going to be growing because of the tremendous amount of sales around the world and his popularity in music and love. It will never stop growing. Since he died, I think it makes $600 million. And I'm so glad and thrilled that I was able to make him the happiest man in the world when he acquired Neverland Ranch. That's where he raised his children. He raised his children. The three children were raised at Neverland Ranch. And I'm so thrilled that the happiest years of his life were spent at Neverland Ranch. I'm so delighted that the children enjoyed this ranch and were there. And I think it's going to, right now it's up for sale for $75 million, I understand. I would like to see it be made into a museum and a theme park, because all the world wants to see Neverland. Everyone in the world wants to go to Neverland. They want to go and visit where Michael Jackson lived and how he lived. And it's wonderful, we can see it on film, and Mr. Nimmer did a fantastic job of showing the beauty within of both the main house and the guest house. And there was five other residences and a 6.5-acre man-made lake right in front of the house and a London bridge that he imported to be built on the property. Michael Jackson did some great things to that ranch. Besides the planting of the flowers and the creation of the zoo, he loved reindeer, and he fell in love with when the reindeer would come at dawn or at sunset to feed on the geraniums that he planted for them to eat. All the reindeer came from the forest. There's a forest behind the ranch, and that forest is a home, a haven for a lot of animals. Coyotes, you name it, all kinds of animals. And Michael loved every kind of animal there is. That's why he also had the cages built for Sue, for the llamas, and the giraffes. He loved every animal there is on this planet. Just like he loves people, every human being, he was such a spiritual being. He connected with the moon, and he prayed to the sky. He and I prayed together all over that ranch before he acquired it. Before he acquired the ranch, we prayed and we walked all over that ranch. He inspected it. He went over every... I stayed a month on the ranch after he decided to buy the ranch. And we walked hand in hand together. And he held my hand, and I was already 60 years old at that time when I sold him the ranch. And he held my hand, and we jumped over creeks. We walked all over the entire ranch. Sometimes they drove us in a truck or in a special cart. We had people show us, but he really wanted to see. Michael was a hands-on person. He was not a laid-back, uninterested person. He was interested in everything. Even how butterflies fed or bees fed. He was interested in every kind of living, breathing thing on this planet, and he especially loved flowers. And I'm so grateful that there's two big bouquets of flowers here in honor of Michael Jackson's anniversary. And I'm sure that we're all thinking about Michael and the family. who are not here right now. They're here in spirit. Michael is here in spirit. And I think the performers that danced and emulated Michael Jackson did a fantastic job. And I wish we could all go to Neverland together as a group. And I'm hoping and praying that we can raise funds for the Michael Jackson Innocent Forever Foundation. I think Mr. Warren Wagner has done a fantastic job, and I'm thrilled to see Tom Mastro, the attorney who won Michael Jackson's Freedom for Us. Every one of you for being here. Thank you for coming. Gloria Berlin.
Stick around to 4 o'clock, please. My whole, I've lost my voice. I've been talking so much. But I've got another celebrity coming. Anyway, my artist son has to leave. She got another appointment. She has
outside, you know, do you feel great today? And I said, well, you know, I feel great about a wonderful legacy. I feel sad about a genius, a humanitarian, a wonderful, wonderful, kind person who went too soon. But nevertheless, we have to celebrate all the blessings he left us. His humanity, his kindness, his artistry, his desire to put others before himself. One of the nicest, kindest, most gentle people I've ever, ever met in my lifetime. I want to mention a couple of things about him, if I can, from the trial. First of all, I think as many of you know, before the trial began, my only sibling, my sister, became terminally ill with cancer. She had a brain tumor and a lung tumor, and she had the brain tumor removed first, and it looked like it was successful. And the neurosurgeon was very optimistic. She didn't have the vision problems and the balance problems that normally accompany this kind of surgery. And she went home from the hospital, and there was a bouquet of flowers bigger than her door with a little poem that was from Michael Jackson. And the second thing I want to tell you was that late in the trial, I started to suffer from vertigo, which, you know, you get out of bed in the morning and you're dizzy, and I actually fall right back down, and I was quite concerned about it. I went to a physician, and he was able to give me some medication. Apparently, there is a spore in the fields in the Santa Maria area that sometimes people from outside, when they experience it, get dizzy. But Michael Jackson called me up when he heard about it. All he cared about was me. His life was on the line. He was looking at the rest of his life in state prison. All he heard about was me. This is who Michael was, okay? This is who Michael was. You're talking about the best known celebrity in the world, one of the wealthiest people in the world, an artistic genius that will never be, you know, repeated. And did he buy a home on the Riviera and just party for himself? No. He wanted to devote his life to children, to animals, to disabled people. He wanted to use his gifts and his blessings to heal the world. And as far as I'm concerned, he absolutely succeeded. I've never been to the school before. I was so happy to see his name on the auditorium. And I'm very, very honored and humbled that I would be invited. And thank you so much for having me.
Afraid to the Jackson family, Michael Jackson's friend and personal attorney did the impossible. Give up some love for Mr. Tom Mizzle. Now, y'all came boxing, man. I know it's exciting, but we got a show to do here. And we got other celebrities coming too.